Welcome back, and to shed more light on the importance of the projects, of the national projects that were inaugurated recently by President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, with a special focus on the fish farming projects. We are joined over the phone by Mr. Rauf Ghafar. He is an economic analyst. Good afternoon, Mr. Rauf.
Good afternoon to you.
So, as I've just said, that the President of Fattah el-Sisi has recently inaugurated Al Fayrouz fish farming project in northeastern Port Said city, among other development projects. So, what is the significance of this project?
The significance is that this project comes within the line of self-sufficiency as far as essential food products and elements. We are looking forward to stop importing any kind of
yes, Mr.
So So I mean, we are the president and the administration is very much along the lines of making Egypt self-sufficient in food particularly. And that is why the fish farm come very much within the context of food sufficiency and food security. We have noticed that despite having a lot of coastlines, we want to conserve the fish in the seas because they are being fished, maybe abused fishing, but by executing a fish farm, we help increase the quantity of fish available for local market. And once we are self-satisfied, which I think we are about to reach, we can even have the possibility to export to neighboring countries, etc.
So, Mr. Rauf, do you think that Egypt can be one of the leading countries in this industry as because of its location? Of course, Egypt is overlooking two seas and it has also the River Nile. So do you think that it can be one of leading industries in Egypt, the fish industry in general?
Yes, and not only because we have two seas and the River Nile, but it helps, of course, but the location of Egypt.
Yes.
We are very much in the center of three continents, and this allows us to export our products easily to, first of all, neighboring Arab countries, to Middle East countries, and to Europe, Asia, and Africa. So, in addition to the resources we have, seas and River Nile, we are very strategically located in a way that we can really export to countries around us.
Also, the president said that also many projects in the field of agricultural land reclamations were implemented and are expected to be inaugurated soon, as well as developing Lake Manzala near Port Said. So also, what is the importance of developing Lake Manzala?
Listen, development is global. I mean, the president does not concentrate on one area and leave the other. The development goes in parallel in all aspects. So we develop in agriculture, we develop in industry, we develop in fish farming. I mean, you name it, we are developing. We heard about the reclamation of 500,000 sedans around the north coast, western north coast. I'm sorry, and this again will help us produce all the basic food products that we need, and again we don't want and on other countries as far as our food is concerned. So this country runs very much within these lines, and he made it very clear that we have to depend on ourselves, not only because the COVID-19 imposed some conditions, but I mean, in general, the president and the administration is looking at producing our own food and not depend on imports.
So yes, Mr. Rauf.
Agricultural development projects come very much within the line.
And finally, I'd like to ask you about developing Egypt's countryside, as it is one of the files that top the agenda of the government and is part of Egypt's Vision 2030. So how do you see this initiative?
Absolutely. The country, under the directives, of course, achieved huge infrastructure projects. And now the president is looking into the well-being and the welfare of the Egyptian citizens. That is why he is developing the countryside, he is developing villages, so that he can improve the quality of life of the Egyptians and present them with honorable way for their lives. And I am sure that not only, we're talking education here, we're talking rural development, we're talking health, etc. Buildings and housing, etc., etc. So he is looking at the welfare and the well-being and the improvement of the quality of life of the Egyptian individual, so that he can produce more and he can serve his country more.
Yes, finally, I'd like to thank you, Mr. Rauf Ghafar, political analyst, for this precious information, and you viewers, short break, and we'll be back with our dear guest, Dr. Magdi Adli, who will talk to us about Egypt's vaccination campaign. So please don't go.